Truck, how you feeling?
Oh.
Man, I just talked to Chuck for you. He's willing to give you an early look if Michael comes out hot again.
It's whatever the team needs, coach.
Okay. We can't lose a fourth straight game to these guys. Your number gets called. Knock Michael off his rhythm.
Bad boys. Let's go.
Let's do this.
Situated on the shores of the Detroit River, the beautiful Renaissance Center. Welcome to Auburn Hills, Michigan. Here with Clark Kellogg, Mike Fratello, and sideline reporter David Aldridge, I'm Kevin Harlan. Mike, on this chilly winter evening, are we witnessing a succession at the Palace?
It certainly seems that way. For a long time, these Pistons beat and bullied Chicago. But the times, they are changing. The Bulls seem to have inherited the throne.
Mike, indeed they have. Everything going Chicago's way. Clark, they've won 8 consecutive games against the Pistons.
And that after getting swept in the Eastern Conference Finals. You better believe they'll be motivated tonight, Kevin.
Tip-off goes to Chicago. And so the Bulls down the floor. As Paxson gets it over to Jordan, he'll work on Dumars. The turnaround. Good, Michael! It's Scotty over to Michael. Here's the three. Caught it!
MJ's looking to prove something here.
It's Jordan. Looks over the defense. Closed by Dumars and hammers it down.
Goodness!
Right over Rodman. Timeout, Detroit.
MJ has come out on fire.
Truck, you're up. Come on. All right, time for what we talked about. Coach needs you to get out there, play defense, and make Michael work for it.
Coach, I'm going to make him work on both ends.
No. Listen to me. I need you to focus on defense. That's it.
Coach, you know me. I'm going to do whatever you ask of me. But right now, we start winning this game when we make Mike work each edge of the court. And I'm going to do that. I got you.
Get out there.
No problem, Coach.
All right, hustle up. Let's go. Let's go.
Let's go. Come on.
And we welcome you back here to the Palace in Auburn Hills. With Joe Dumars dealing with the bad back and having a tough time, Clark, against Michael Jordan. The Pistons trying something different here, bringing Truck in early to give him a turn against the reigning MVP.
And you know, Kevin, to be candid, even before the back troubles, Dumars had struggled against MJ this season. Just 12 points per game on 29% shooting from the floor. Coach hoping Truck can stem the tide.
And we've said it before, but certainly some history between these two teams. Central Division rivals, the Pistons sent the Bulls home 3 years in a row and routed to titles in 89 and 90. But with the Bulls' championship and last year's playoffs, it seems at last they have the upper hand.
No good on the second free throw. And Clark, the Pistons were that great roadblock to the Bulls' title aspirations. It seemed like every year Chicago got a little bit closer.
You're exactly right, Kevin. Each playoff, they pushed the series just a little bit further until finally, last season, they swept the Pistons in the Eastern Conference Finals, breaking through to win the franchise's first ever NBA title.
And if I'm headed down the dark alley, I'll take Truck by my side. Nobody's going to want any trouble.
Yeah, I agree there, Mike. He doesn't say a lot. He doesn't have to. One look is enough for him to get his message across.
And for more on Truck, let's go across court to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, big minutes for Truck, who's bounced around quite a bit. This is his 5th team in 9 seasons, so I'm sure there's added pressure for him to play well. Back to you.
Pressure indeed, D.A., thank you. Well, we always talk about the pressure on the stars, Clark, but for those fringe players, they're just trying to hang around.
And now he's tasked with taking on the MVP, Kevin. That's a really tall order.
1:44 left in the first. The Bulls leading by 4. Here's Jordan. And again, Jordan with the bucket over Truck.
I'll tell you, trying to defend Michael Jordan one-on-one is just about impossible.
Agree with that. Incredibly quick first step he has, and if he doesn't blow by you, he can probably overpower you.
Fleming the pass to Lambeer. Walker with it. The Pistons working the ball around now. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Lambeer with a screen on Cartwright, and the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. Sally, he's checked in for Detroit. Chicago calls timeout. And so we'll take a break from the action and let these players get a well-deserved moment of rest. Also a chance for them to rehydrate with Gatorade.
Staying fresh is the key to being competitive throughout a game. And keeping themselves well hydrated is the surest way to do that.
Seconds left to play here in the first. At the elbow, it's Jordan. Another bucket for Jordan, scoring on Truck. And a third-round pick back in 1983, Mike Truck got his start on those great Celtics teams.
No better place to learn about winning. Four straight finals runs from 84 to 87 and two NBA titles.
Jordan against Truck. Clock at four. Here's Sally. Good for the basket. Starting off one for one with that shot.
It's never easy trying to keep him off the glass. He's an absolute beast down there.
Armstrong kicks to Jordan. Here's Purdue. No good. Michael Jordan getting it done for the Bulls. They kept going to him again and again, and he delivered with a monster quarter. Back to the action in just a minute. And we welcome you back to the second quarter here at the Palace of Auburn Hills for the fourth matchup of the regular season between the Detroit Pistons and the Chicago Bulls. And the Pistons coming off a 1-2 road trip, Mike. Their last game, a loss in Miami, where they shot, 11 free throws to the Heat's 41 free throw attempts.
Yeah, Joe Dumars was the only Piston starter to get to the line. Meanwhile, everyone from Miami seemed to be living there. So that was the game.
Jordan against Truck. And the pass to Sally. Thomas up top. Will Purdue grabs the miss. Chicago leading by six. Hops it up for Jordan. Jordan gets another over Truck. And defensively, the Pistons have been, Mike, as stout as ever. But scoring the ball this season, that has been the challenge.
And their backcourt is normally responsible for the bulk of their scoring, along with Aguirre. But they'll need somebody else to chip in offensively.
Fleming the pass to Sally. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. And Mike, for the season, the Bulls are among the league leaders in assists at almost 28 a game.
They moved the ball well, and they had to improve in that area in order to finally overcome the Pistons' defensive scheme, famously known as the Jordan Rules.
Here's King, following the bucket by the Pistons. Purdue with a screen on Walker. Here's Hobson. That's no good. Couldn't get his first shot to go. Mike leading the league in scoring for the sixth consecutive season, the great Michael Jordan.
Surprise, surprise. A hair under 30 points per game this season, and that's a dip from what he's accustomed to.
A nice shot by Bedford.
Well, size-wise, that was a mismatch. Great idea to work it inside.
Armstrong passes to King. Armstrong against Thomas. Here's Hobson. Scoreless thus far. Purdue the screen. From the high post. Hobson's shot is off.
That's not a bad look. He missed that chance, but he'll get them to fall if he gets space like that.
And the Bulls, Mike, so explosive offensively.
A great 1-2 punch with Jordan and Pippen. And with Paxson, Hodges, and Armstrong, they surround them with shooters.
That is good. And the Bulls' lead is cut down now to just two on the basket from Thomas. And so Jordan will bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. They get it back and slam dunk by Purdue.
That is why Purdue is out there. Give this squad some energy.
And now the first timeout called here for Detroit.
Keeping up all the motion. Give me your Pistons dancer.
So Detroit going with an almost entire new group here. Lambeer's checked in for Bedford. Through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. In Chicago, they're up by five. And we'll be back right after halftime for the start of the third quarter. We'll see you in a bit. And we're back for the second half of play here in Auburn Hills, Michigan, as the Pistons look to get a win against their rival, the Chicago Bulls. The Bulls leading by five, and a close game here, Mike, as we begin the second half.
Well, that's been the story in the previous contest this season between the Bulls and Pistons. Can Detroit follow through down the stretch? And 21 points per game this season for Scottie Pippen, the highest mark of his career.
Yeah, very impressive, Mike, but he was held to 9 points in their last game on Saturday against Minnesota. Got poked in the eye and had blurred vision, which certainly had an impact.
Here's Fleming after the made shot from Scottie Pippen. Jumars the pass to Fleming. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. So at Chicago now, 7 point differential. Pippen kicks to Jordan. Shoots over Truck. And there's Jordan. That's good on the assist by Pippen. Pippen's got his fourth assist in this one. Well, you know, he's bounced around, Clark, at times rode the bench, but Truck has always stayed ready.
Yeah, I respect that about how he prepares. A great teammate, a rugged defender. Here late in his career, he's fit in nicely with the Bad Boy Piston.
A very accurate shooter out at the arc. Dumars can really hurt you from range if you don't chase him off the perimeter.
Paxson outside. Grant outside. Jordan is double. Six to shoot. Here's Pippen. Detroit with the rebound. Third quarter of play with just over a minute and a half gone by. Truck drives in. And Rodman with the slam.
Well, we've seen Rodman do that often. Going up, getting that board, and getting the putback. Exactly what you want from him inside. You know, there's a sense in Detroit that they just don't get as many calls as they did when they were the champions. I don't know if that's true or not, but that's how they feel.
Yeah, rightly or not, they feel they're more scrutinized when they're guarding and not getting the benefit of the doubt when they draw contact on offense.
And finished off by Truck.
Truck recognized the defense softening and took advantage.
Paxson outside. Grant with a screen on Dumas. The offensive rebound. Passes it to Paxson. Outside, Jordan. Grant outside. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. No good. They had a chance to end the run there. The Pistons trailer. Truck deciding where to go with it. Lambeer with a screen on Jordan. Pass to Lambeer. Back to Truck for the tie. And it's Chicago with the rebound. Grant's got four rebounds now tonight. And player of the month in January, Clark, it's Dennis Rodman. 11 points a game and 21 rebounds a game. Phenomenal.
It is phenomenal. But how about this? Tack on 2.5 assists per game, too. And the Pistons with a 10-5 record in that stretch.
Now here's Thomas. He has 7 over Paxson. Thomas's shot is off. Paxson with the ball. Picked up by Rodman. And they double up Jordan. Down low. Here's Cartwright. And no good that time. Some solid defense by Rodman. There's the dish to Truck. We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now. Rodman with a screen on Grant. Double team on Truck. The kick out to Dumars. Good on the three-point shot. Dumars got a pair of threes now here in the third for Detroit.
You know, Michael Jordan has led the Bulls to the playoffs every season since he was drafted. That's seven times in all. But it took time for them to be a serious contender.
And the Pistons had been that obstacle in their path. But last season, the Bulls finally overcame them in convincing fashion.
Chicago calls timeout. Pistons. Sally, he's checked in for Lambeer. Sellers come. Enzo Jordan will bring it up for Chicago. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. And Thursday, the Pistons hosting the Milwaukee Bucks. Mike handing out free windbreakers to the first 4,000 fans. A nice deal.
And for the fans braving the harsh Michigan winter, enjoy those windbreakers. You might want to layer up a bit with those, just saying.
And so it's Detroit with the ball, following the miss by Michael Jordan. To the wing from 18 feet away, bullseye. Jordan's got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for Chicago. Pistons trail by 7,
and we're seeing Michael Jordan in vintage form.
The Pistons, much like the rest of the league, Mike, we've seen it all season long, seem to have no answer for the heir apparent.
And then Sally with the dunk.
Beautiful room service pass by Truck. I mean, that's exactly why his teammates like playing with him. This guy is unselfish.
A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. Jordan against Truck. Jordan can't get it to go. And so it's Detroit with it. Right side, Truck. It up for Jordan, and the dunk by Jordan.
The ball goes up and Jordan brings it down. Nothing the defense can do about it.
And the Pistons having trouble generating enough offense.
Yeah, they've got to find a way to manufacture points. Otherwise, the Bulls will continue to have their number.
Now, here's Thomas. Outside, Truck. Pocket 6. And again, Detroit turns it over. The Pistons making a change here. Sellers checked in. And a change for the Bulls. Williams, he's checked in for King. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Jordan passes to Hobson. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. The shot's good. Jordan's got the lead up to 9 now for the Bulls.
And right now, MJ has it going on. His teammates should just continue to get him the rock.
And here's Truck from the arc. No good by Truck. Jordan playing the defense that time.
And Truck is finding buckets hard to come by. Jordan reminding us he's a former defensive player of the year.
And for the season, Mike, Isaiah Thomas averaging a little over 7 assists a game.
Down quite a bit from his career average, but productive as ever with his scoring.
Mark 11 consecutive All-Star appearances for the terrific Isaiah Thomas.
He's one of the best to ever do it. No question about it. He's never missed being an All-Star in his decorated career.
Here's what Detroit's going with right now. Beers checked in for Sally. Rodman comes in for Sellers. And it's Dumars in for Walker. And Mike, how about Dennis Rodman? Averaging over 6 offensive rebounds a game this season.
And usually he looks to pass out. The Pistons wouldn't mind him trying to score a little bit more off those rebounds.
Here's Dumars. Following the basket by Michael Jordan. Back to Thomas. Over Pippen. Thomas, no luck. The Bulls leading by 10. Here's Hobson. Lambeer grabs the board. Lambeer's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Outside, Truck. Pass to Rodman. And too much time in the lane. They get called for the 3-second violation.
And a misstep like this will not help things.
Yeah, bad mistake, no question. They got to brush it off and find a way to get back in this one.
The Bulls making a switch here. Paxson's checked in.
And when you look at Scottie Pippen's growth to an elite level, I think it's really what's made this Bulls team so unstoppable.
And you pair him with Jordan, most teams simply don't have an answer for the both of them coming at you.
Providing exactly what the team needs from him, Grant uses his reach to reel in that offensive rebound and make sure they convert.
Outside, Truck. Rodman with a screen on Jordan. They find Jay on the way. It's off by Truck. MJ playing him close.
Jordan not letting his guard down against Truck. Not relaxing at all, giving him his full attention defensively.
Grant sets a screen for Jordan. There's the pass to Paxson. Good, and Grant gets the assist. And the Bulls lead by 14.
John Paxson, a very dangerous spot-up shooter. That's exactly the role he plays on this team.
Well, not his best year shooting from outside at around 32%, and his scoring average down to 6.3 a game.
Here's Dumars. He feeds it to Rodman. And the jam by Dennis Rodman.
Boy, Dumars does such a really good job sharing the rock. A willing passer.
And here's Jordan. He'll bring it up for the Bulls. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points. Inside. Cartwright, the pass to Grant. Pippen outside. Paxson outside. And the Bulls continue their reign. 4 wins in a row. And
thank you to all of our fans who joined us tonight to cheer on the team. Please exit the building carefully, and we'll see you again soon.
See, I hear that. To me, though, I'd rather not let them get in the rhythm at all.
Don't let them get comfortable.
Play good D and disrupt. Don't let them get in the zone in the first place.
Yep, for sure.
Next time you're playing and one of the ops gets it going, instead of trying to answer bucket for bucket,
sell out for the steal.
Exactly. Defense wins game.
Yes, sir.
you, MP.